Pratik. I am from Third Sense CSE department. Today I will be presenting data set Asia Cup data analysis. First we will see which are the teams which have participated in the Asia Cup. So the Pakistan, Sri Lanka, India, as you can see, Bangladesh, Hong Kong, UAE and Afghanistan. So one further. So first, Asia Cup, it has been took place in two formats, that is ODI and T20. So for the first 12 season, it was played in ODI format from 1984 to 2014, and then from 2016, it was played in T20 format. We can see ODI versus T20 fight chart. So almost four times ODI format the Asia Cup has been played. So the next thing we'll look up in presentation is toss. So toss also plays an important role in the match. So okay, the team which have won the match and also won the toss with respect the team which have won the match who also won the toss. You can see the pie chart. So almost you can say that the toss has favored the match. The teams were towards winning. That was in ODI format. In T20 format also you can see the toss has favored the winning side. And then now the results. So whichever team has won by batting first in the ODI format, you can see the most number of wins. Sri Lanka have got most number of wins. While India, you can see has comparatively less wins. But if when you consider bowling first, you can see India has almost outplayed everyone. In T20 also India and Sri Lanka are like well balanced. Also in bowling first in T20 also India and Sri Lanka are almost equal. And Pakistan it is better for them in bowling first than batting first. So most wins you can see the light blue lines represent India, green represent Pakistan and dark blue represent Sri Lanka. You can see more number of light blue and dark blue lines than green. So that represents the team in each season. India and Sri Lanka have got more wins. So next let's see the distribution of matches. I have considered the data that at least 10 matches should have played and then I have plotted a pie chart. So you can see Mirpur has more number of matches in this Asia Cup. So PO team, the player of the match. This is also I have sorted by taking the players which have at least won 4 PO teams. And the one who is leading this is Virat Kohli. Virat Kohli has awarded most player of the matches. The total number is 10 and that is the highest in history of Asia Cup. So now let's go to 4s and 6s. So in ODIs, the team with most number of 4s and 6s is India. And Sri Lanka and Pakistan are also very competitive. In T20s also you can see most number of 4s and 6s are scored by India, Sri Lanka, Pakistan. So these three are the major teams in Asia Cup. Now let's move on to the runs and wickets. So total runs scored by each team in ODIs. You can see here also India and Sri Lanka are almost the same. Well, coming to wicket taken, India, Sri Lanka, Pakistan, Bangladesh. So in T20s, the stats are almost same in both ODIs and T20s. The team India, Pakistan and Sri Lanka are almost in lead in every format. Let's see which team have won how many times. So there are only 3 champions having to win the Asia Cup. They are India, Sri Lanka and Pakistan, with India having the most number of titles. So this stats is from only 1994 to 2022. It does not include the last year's 2023 win. So then 7. And the most number of runner-up titles you can see, Sri Lanka has 6 Bangladesh has three. So we can consider both Sri Lanka and Bangladesh as undercooking because they have played finals many times but unable to win the finals. So next, let's see each player's batting performance. In ODI, I have brought this bowler considering at least considering the players who have at least scored 600 runs. So you can see the highest score in ODIs is currently being held. The record currently being held by Virat Kohli with the most number of highest score. And considering strike rate, they have Jayasurya. And considering the batting average also, they have MS Dhoni in this aspect. So now let's see the most number of centuries and 50s in ODI. Many players have scored 50s, but I have considered the players who have scored at least 2 centuries, and we can see the stats. So now in T20s, the right thing, I have plotted the batting average striking rate versus players for those who have scored at least 150 runs. You can see Virat Kohli in this format also. Next, centuries and 50s in ODIs. You can see many number of half centuries, that is 50s, in ODIs, but you can you have only one century. That is also had by coming to bowling stats, I have bar graph which shows wickets, bowling average and strike rates in ODI. We have also sorted the players who have at least took 20 wickets. And now, this is for maiden overs and economy rates. I have sorted by taking maximum economy rate as 4. Those who exceeded are not in this graph. Next, in T20s, we will see the same stats. Wickets, bowling average and strike rate. So here also I have sorted by taking at least the players who took at least 8 wickets. And the next maiden over and economy rates the same as we saw in ODIs. So here also I have sorted by taking maximum economy as 6. Now wicket keeping we can see this is a bar graph containing stats of the data of the players who have made at least 10 dismissals. This includes catches and stumpings. You can see Sangakkara and Dhoni are currently leading. In T20s, SP Patil and MS Dhoni, they have highest number of dismissals. So overall comparing the Asia Cup stats, I can say that team which are more consistent are India and Sri Lanka. So that's the conclusion. Thank you.